town was sort of a kind of a middle or the lower middle grade town with a large population of mercantile community, the Jain, as we call them. Very well-known, term. Jains are generally merchants. And then there are a few other communities, but large number of Dalit, or what we call Dalit now, they are the depressed. But it's not a farming land. It had some industry. It had actually a cotton mill. And majority of the population worked there. It was just across the street. In fact, it was in front of the street I lived in. And there was a wall that separated our lane from the mill. And I do remember all those dreams that we had of what was beyond the wall. So there was a river on the right, the town on the left, wall in front. We walked around the town, and I do remember that on the whole it was a kind of a very broadly liberal sort of a Gandhian type of a atmosphere. You know, it was communities generally sort of managed their managed living to, but still there were ghettos. The Muslims lived in a quarter, which was a poor quarter, near the mill or around the mill, and large number of mill hands were Muslims. On the other side was rather a kind of a area where many Jain families lived. And then there were many others, around. I had a great friend and benefactor, who was a Jain. His name was Shanti Lal Shah. And in my early days, I got interested in different belief systems. I was curious as to who these Jains are, what do they do. And when I got interested in art, I must have chanced upon some paintings. And once he told me that, in our temple we have paintings. Would you like to see? I was quite scared, but I went. And he showed me some odd, old things that they had. He was a kind of a culture man, not interested in business, although he ran a business. And he sort of had few boys around, mostly my generation, my classmates. And we formed a little culture group there. And he would organize activities. We used to have some kind of a fair, a sort of a mela. And Shanti Bhai would be involved in organizing it and all that. At a later stage, I learned that my friend Hasmukh Shah, who became secretary of the Prime Minister in India and all that, was originally from Surendranagar. And he also was part of that kind of, activity.